Retention of water on the property is important. I already talked about it in the previous video, where I showed what methods of retention of rainwater we have on the property. Now I'm going to talk about what other plants we have for rainwater retention and use. I'm now at the highest point of the property. There's only a duck pond, no foil, and since there is so little water here, we want to use this hole for a large covered tank to hold several tens of cubic meters of water. We plan to fill it in such a way that we will pump water from the lake, which overflows in autumn, winter and spring, into this upper reservoir. The tank will be buried. Water will be pumped by a hand pump and also by a downspout. I'm now at the children's house, from the roof of which we will collect rainwater into the IBC container. Water will be used when someone is staying here. There will be one container, the gutter is already prepared on each side of the roof, and the container will be in the middle. It will be used for hand washing and possibly an outdoor shower will be built here. I'm now in a place where nothing really grows here, only grass. We want to build an underground greenhouse in this place, and again rainwater will be collected from its roof again. If the water runs out here, it can be released from the future reservoir at the very top. In a previous video about current water retention, I showed how water overflows from these tanks behind the earthship when they are full. It flows here into the puddles and then to the lake. In order to get rid of puddles, we want to transform this terrain into cascading terraces down to the lake for gradual soaking. Here is some unused space where the terraces would be graded and shade plants could find their place here. Now I'm looking at the free space in front of the greenhouse. Here in this place flows the stream that I talked about in the last video. It starts over there at the end from the field drainage. And here in this free space we want to build a swimming pool, just a duct hole in the ground lined with stones. The overflow from it will be the continuation of the stream all the way down to the lake. The swimming pool will be filled from the cleaning pot that we will build in this place. It will be a natural purification pond with plants. The water will get here from the roof of the greenhouse and eventually from the roof of the workshop. Here I am in the lowest part of the plot, right next to the biggest lake we have here, and in this place we want to build another greenhouse for cultivation, and from its roof again there will be stored rainwater. It will go either to the tank or straight into the pond. This view is of the last unused part in our garden. We want to build small experimental buildings here, and of course each will have its own roof. Water from these roofs will be diverted to underground tanks, and the water will be used in the houses. Furthermore, each house will produce grey water, which will also be used for example, watering. I would also like to have a small pond between the tiny houses to make the space really special. Here you can see the map of our land with our current water retention situation, and I will follow it up with other plants. This is the highest point of the property, and there will be a large tank into which the water from the lower lake will be transferred. Then there is a tank from the roof of the underground greenhouse. Here is a children's house that will have an IBC container for water from the roof. This is where I get to the experimental houses, and there will be underground rainwater tanks. The water will be from the roof and for needs of the house. There will be a small pond between the house to make the place special. There will also be a greenhouse and a water tank from the roof by the large lake. Last year I have a swimming pool in front of the earthship. I used up the free areas that we have available for water and its retention. No more places will be created here, but who knows, maybe we'll get lucky and get the surrounding fields that we are aiming for, and there will definitely be more water elements here. I watched this little pond for a while and even thought it doesn't look very nice, pleasing to the human eye. I think it's not so terrible for the animals. I saw wasps here sitting on the green matter, also dragonfly and frog jumped into it a while ago. So even if it doesn't look good for us humans, for animals even this ugly thing can have a lot of good in it. So why not leave it to them for their own good?